prepared. So thank you all of you. And first of all, I must say that Aditi, you do very good. And yes, I should acknowledge that you have just done it very excellently. So keep it on. And so today I would like to try to discuss the last part, last few lines rather, of book one of Paradise Lost by Milton. That is from line number 152 onwards. Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely audible.
Okay, sir. Actually, sir, there is my problem actually. Okay. So before moving to our discussion, I would like to go back to the part, or you can say scene, where we have found that the pandemonium, that is council chamber of the angels, or the meeting place, or the meeting hall, you can say rather, has been successfully built. And now from line number 752 onwards, that is our today discussion, we will get a description about how the assembly was going on and how the fallen angels or rebel angels were summoned in meeting in that very pandemonium. Okay. And one thing that we have already known from the very fifth speech of Saturn, where he talked about the necessity of discussion with the rebel angels, with the angels, about what they should do in future in their endeavor to fight against God. And there we have found that he mentioned clearly that the war would continue, but it won't be fought face to face, rather by guile and deception. Okay, so after the construction of pandemonium, Saturn is going to discuss his future plan and get the approval from the fallen angels. But at the same time, it's too true that the decision has already been made in his mind. So you see that Saturn is a very much diplomatic. Saturn is a very much full leader. So he is just convening the meeting to suggest to the followers that he cares for their opinion. Actually, this is not. However, the fallen angels finally are now summoned, and here is the description. So let's start the text. Meanwhile, the winged heralds, here winged refers to the fallen angels, by command of sovereign power, sovereign that is supreme, a supreme power that is Saturn, with awful ceremony, stately ceremony, and trumpet sound throughout the host proclaim a solemn council for it to be held at Pandemonium, the high capital of Saturn and peers. So now by the command of Saturn, the supreme power or the sovereign leader, the heralds of the fallen angels proclaimed with stately ceremony and the sound of the trumpets at meeting or a council would be held at the Pandemonium, and where they all would assemble, and before them Saturn would going to discuss his future plan for the action. Okay, their summons called from every band and square regiment, that is squadron, and from every, that means from each company, each visions that the fallen angels have, by place, that is rank, or choice done by Saturn. The worthiest, here the worthiest of the angels, or the worthiest, they announced at once with hundreds and with thousands, tropping came attended, tropping the spring. So after the proclamation, fallen is the worthiest of fallen angels, or the spirits, either by their work or by the favor that granted to them by Saturn, attended the meeting or the council at once with the hundreds and thousands of followers. And then what happened? All accesses, access means entry points, were strong. Strong is crowded. The gates and ports wide. So this means the gates. So what happened? Naturally, all the endpoints, all the gates, the ports were all now crowded. Crowded the fallen angels or the rebel angels. And but chief the spacious hall. But one thing that though all the entry points, all the gates were crowded with the rebels, but mainly it was the large hall. It was the meeting hall of the pandemonium where everyone just packed in. So you see that such was the vast number of angels that such a big large hall was overcrowded with them. Okay, and now Milton here uses a very wonderful simile to make understand the situation of that very angels in the pandemonium. Though like a covered field, means leased or the places that the enclosed places for combat, where champions here the Christian knight of the Middle Ages would won't ride in arms and at the sultan's chair. Sultan is here is sultan. Defied the best of penim, pagan, silvery to mortal, mortal is that battle, combat or career with lens that means fight. So what Milton is trying to say that to give us an idea of largeness of the hall, there is the pandemonium, the meeting of the pandemonium. I mean, compares the medieval or the tournament fields, and even these big fields of combat, that the Christian knights used to challenge the Christian knights of the Middle Ages used to challenge the pagan Saracens to fight, ending in death or to mock fight a spear in the presence of Sultan. Okay, now thick swarm that means gathered in great number, both on the ground and in the air. So the fallen angels are in large number. That's why the air, the floor, every place of the hall was crowded with the fallen angels who actually were waiting for the assembly to begin. Okay, and brassed with the heat of rustling sounds, which really hissed with the rustling wings. So why rustling wings? Why Milton is saying here that rustling wings? Actually, we will soon know it very well in the next lines when Milton is Milton compares the fallen angels with the bees. Okay, so here actually the rustling sound of their wings is the buzzing sound of the bees. Okay. And one thing that were the bees actually buzzing, because they must be discussing very serious something very serious, So the fallen angels, in the same manner, fallen angels assembled for discussing very important political matters. Obviously, that is obvious the future course of their action. Okay, so as bees in springtime, when the sun with Taurus rides, Taurus is one of the zodiac signs of the sun, pour forth their populous youth about the hive in clusters. Clusters means a huge number. They among fresh dews and flowers, that is dewy flowers, fly to and fro or on the smooth plank, that is the projected platform, the sub of their straw built citadel. So citadel, that is the little city or small city. New rubbed with balm. Their balm, actually the wax, the glued wax, and expatiate, that means walk abroad, confer, discussion, their state affairs, public affairs. So here Milton is saying that when the sun enters Taurus in springtime. Just as bees swarm thick about the hive, and some of the bees are found gathering honey from the dewy flowers, and another group of bees are, you know, found one here and there on the projected platform, which serves as the suburb to the straw-built hive, which actually glue with wax. And as they walk abroad, they discuss their public affairs. So in the same way, in the same manner, the innumerable angels just swarm thick, and you know, so thick the airy crowd swarmed and were straightened means cramped for space till the signal given. So in the same manner, the innumerable angels just swarm thick and were cramped for space. So they are not getting the, you know, proper space. And till the signal given. So they are signal for the meeting to start. And now I would like to draw your attention to the fact that Milton uses this simile in a very, you know, symbolic manner. Because why are the fallen angels being compared with the bees? Actually, it's not just as a, you know, innocent actions of the bees in collecting honey that fallen angels have been described. Rather, they are found busy in worse thing, because we are all know that they all have been, you know, gathered here. They were all gathered here to discuss or to plan how they can hinder, or you may say obstruct or destroy God's plan. So here they are planning. So all the fallen angels with the Saturn gathered in the pandemonium to hatch a plot against God, and to take revenge to the God, the Almighty, out of his anger. And we already know from Aditi that there are the various emotions of Saturn, especially the anger. So out of anger, Saturn is now going to hatch a plot against God to destroy his beautiful, you know, design, to destroy the state of his design. Okay, so thank you for, and then one thing, last of all thing, that here is a phrase, straw-built citadel. Here actually Milton is, you know, using an ironical, you know, comment on the multiple effort for building the pandemonium, because how much beautiful or great the pandemonium is, but it means nothing in comparison to the God's heaven, or we can say rather God's paradise. So thank you again, and please forgive me if I made any mistake. Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Before I make any comment, overall it was a nice presentation, Neela. Now, other students, if you have any question to ask Neela. Any question? Any comment? Any difference of opinion if you have? No? Okay, then, presuming that you have understood what Neela tried to say here, I have, first of all, I would like to say that, thank you, Neela, you attempted, that is very important, that you had that courage to take this opportunity and say, well, I'm also going to make a peer teaching presentation. So I congratulate you on that you have made us give us a second schedule, a second slot to you. Yeah, that is good. That's very encouraging. In fact, to me as a teacher, that at least some of you are getting that confidence. Regarding your presentation, it was quite a nice one. You have understood those lines very clearly, as it seems. And quite convincingly, very student friendly, you explain the lines. But one or two things that I would like to comment on. You are a bit hasty. Try to take more time. Try to believe in yourself that yes, you know what you are saying. You were a bit hasty, and therefore, when you were reading the lines of the text, sometimes you were jumping from one word to another. That you can avoid. And this will easily happen once you keep on doing this. I mean, this is not your first opportunity. You take this opportunity, try to speak as much as possible, and gradually you would see that you are gaining in confidence, and then you would not really become hasty at all. That is one suggestion to you. A word here and there when you read the lines. Actually, especially I would like to comment on that simile where the rustling of the winds of the fallen angels were being compared to a simile, to a similarity with the bees humming in and trying to collect honey, etc. Actually, it is more a contrast than a comparison. So though Milton has presented it as a simile, you can understand that the bees are doing something productive, whereas the Satan has only one intention, and that is to destroy. So that is a very important point for us to note. Right. And all other things that you talked about were very nicely presented, and you have been very explicit in your presentation. And regarding Mulciber, you had just touched upon that. Straw built citadel. And you rightly said it's an ironic comment on Mulciber's architecture. Because try to understand, when you compare it with straw built, straw is something very, very transient, very brittle. Any moment it can break down. So there is that particular hit. You can understand meaning thereby that is of no use. Right. And I think there was some audio problem. Because of that also, some words were not very clearly audible to me. I don't know whether all other students could hear all the words that you were saying, but I could not hear all the words. I had to guess that perhaps this is what you have been saying. And that is one of the problems of the online platform. Otherwise, it's a very good one. And now coming back to Aditi's presentation, I already made that it was a very long one, and Aditi